As much as we wouldn't want to believe so, the English language is rather limited when it comes to, the words that we could use to describe music or, bands. Take, for example, the word weird. That's a word you could use to describe 50 odd bands. You could call Animal Collective weird, you could call Captain Beefheart weird, you could call Miles Davis weird. And all three of those will mean something completely different. But take my word for it here, Shudder to Think is weird. And by extension, their 1994 album Pony Express record is weird as well. This was a major label record release, not just some indie band on some indie label throwing some indie shit at the indie wall. This is a band that got paid a lot of money to make a big record that would be promoted with music videos and all that jazz. And then, in the most glorious fashion, decided to make the weirdest thing that came out that year and probably for a few years after. There's bands who are very much odd and they live through that oddness, but what Shudder to Think has that a lot of those bands don't have is this weird sense of self-critique and, I guess, self-acknowledgement. I can sit through albums that are consistently mind-boggling, like something by Can or King Crimson. But Pony Express record is the musical equivalent of a bad acid trip. It's constantly shifting and there's movement from one section to another that don't really make all that much sense. And the lead singer sounds like Freddie Mercury while the rest of the band sounds like Fugazi on a bad day. And all 15 times that I've listened to this, I've had a massive headache. But you know what? I think it's all worth it. I think that this is an album worth breaking your brain for, because this album represents a rather significant moment in the history of music where somehow everything lined up perfectly enough that a band as obtuse and as infuriating as Shudder to Think would ever be allowed to put out an album as insane as this one. Shudder to Think started out in the post-hardcore scene, playing with a bunch of other bands on the world-famous Discord Records, and somehow they were too weird for that scene as well, because pretty soon they gravitated out of that into I guess, a corner of their own. No one sounds like Craig Wedren. More accurately, no one chooses to sing like Craig Wedren, at least not over music like this, and yet he pulls it off. Listen to the way he opens the album with the song Hit Liquor. This is one of two singles from this album, and it happens to be the more conventional of the two. Ex-French T-shirt may be the nicest sounding one, at least harmonically, but structurally, the song feels like one big glossy middle finger. About a minute and 25 seconds into this 4-minute track, the song morphs into this repeating one chord refrain over which the lead singer is singing, "Hold back the road that goes so that the others may do that you let me in just to pour me down their mouths." And yes, I did not misread any of that. That sentence is nonsensical, and I'm pretty sure they know that. This refrain then repeats for the rest of the track, and the fact that the track fades out with them still singing this makes me think that, given the chance, they would have continued. And you know what? I love it. I think this song is perfect. I don't think the song could have been any better. And the fact that it's paired with this ballsy, far out music video featuring a bald headed man in a goatee, plastered in makeup with painted fingernails. This shit played on MTV. This is 94, which means it was playing alongside whatever the hell Weezer released that year, and some Soundgarden and Pearl Jam shit. This band made it their mission to somehow aggravate or confuse the shit out of 90s kids. And I'm not cherry picking examples either. This whole album is like this. It's this constant rotating mirror of dissonant guitar chords and howling vocals. And that's not to say that there aren't prettier moments on this record, because trust me, there are. Craig Wedren is a fantastic vocalist, and in many ways it will be his voice that will carry you through a lot of this stuff. And again, this is not some basement recording with shitty sound quality. This is a professionally recorded record, and it sounds good, quality-wise. And that somehow only adds to, I guess, the wondrousness of this band and this album. They were given a chance few bands have, which is to make a go at mainstream success. And they decided to use the funding and the support to create an album that would definitely not sit well with normal listeners. And this isn't the case of a band that gets so self-absorbed that they don't know that they're making weird music. This was very much intentional. This record was crafted to sound the way it does. Every note is intentional and every chord belongs. I'm a fan of difficult music. I like albums that challenge me and give me something more. And in most of those cases, it's just getting used to the sound of a band. It's getting used to the timbres and getting used to the song structures. And once that happens, a lot of that music becomes normal. It becomes something I make peace with and something I can accept. But it's just not the case with Shudder to Think. This record will always confound me. It will always leave my head spinning. And it'll probably give me a headache every time I listen to it, but it's worth it. It's a unique experience that you will not get anywhere else, and it's an example of a band pushing boundaries in a way that wasn't seen at the time. That still isn't seen today. I don't think a record like this could exist at any other point in time. In the heat and the macho atmosphere of the 90s, they were incorporating glam rock into the art punk that they were making. This is not a band that was very much liked when they first came out. There's an interesting moment in an interview from 2008 where the interviewer is recounting a moment when the band opened for Fugazi and the crowd reacted by throwing coins and shouting the word faggot. Craig responded by saying that this was a common occurrence. I'm quoting here. "We've always sort of thrived on adversity and almost enjoyed that kind of friction and tension." And those are probably the most accurate words you could use to define this band's music. There's friction and tension. And it will rub you the wrong way the first couple of times you listen to it. However, you will not forget this record.